children, good morning to all. Welcome back to class 12 economic online class. We were discussing Indian economy chapter 7 employment and related issues. In the last class we have discussed the meaning of worker. So all those who are engaged in the production activities in whatever capacity, high or low, are termed as worker. And we have already discussed about different types of employment, that is hired workers and self-employed. Then hired workers is further divided into casual worker, regular salary workers, and also discussed the data related to participation of people in employment. So today we would focus on employment in firm, factories and offices, that is employment in secondary and tertiary sector. Employment can take place in various industrial sectors. So there are three industrial sectors in an economy. They are, first one, primary sector. It includes agriculture, forestry, logging, ashing, mining and quarrying. Then the secondary sector includes manufacturing, construction, electricity, gas and water supply. Then also service sector, it otherwise known as tertiary sector, it includes trade, transport, storage and services. So these are the various industrial sectors of an economy. With economic development, labors flow from agricultural sector to industrial sector and also service sector. And during this process of development, workers migrate from rural area to urban area. Then the further development of an economy, the share of employment in industrial sector decline, then service sector enters a period of expansion. So more people employed in service sector. So with development, the more employment, more workforce are shifted from agriculture sector to industrial sector, then industrial sector to service sector. Let us analyze a table. Here, this table shows the distribution of workers by three sectors in India during 2011-12 by regional and also gender wise. From this table, we can understand that primary sector is the main source of employment for majority of worker in India, that is 48.9%. Then secondary sector provide employment only about 24.3% and service sector provide 26.8% of employment opportunity. When we take the rural employment, when we take about the rural employment, 64% of the workforce depend on primary sector in rural area. Then 20.4% in secondary sector, then 15.5% in tertiary sector. Then whereas in urban area, the agriculture is not a major source of employment. Only 6.7% are employed in primary sector in urban area. Then 35% urban people engaged in secondary sector. Then 58% engaged in service sector activities. In the case of gender-wise distribution, both men and women are concentrated in primary sector activities, that is 43.6 and 62.8. From among this, women participation in primary sector is very high, that is 62.8%. This is the share of workforce in three sectors by region and by gender. Okay. Then we moving on to the topic growth and changing structure of employment. So here there are two indicators for measuring growth of an economy. First one GDP and the second one is employment. So we are going to compare growth in GDP and employment. Normally there is increase in GDP, definitely job opportunity should increase. But in India, the scenario is different. Here, even though the GDP is constantly rising, the percentage of employment is not growing up. This situation, that is, GDP is rising without generating employment, is known as jobless growth. Okay, what is the jobless growth? Rising GDP without generating employment is known as jobless growth. So we can say India has in jobless growth. Let us analyze a chart. This chart shows the growth of employment and GDP from 1951 to 2012. The first graph is about GDP growth and second chart is about employment. So in 1951-56, India had 3.6% of growth in GDP, then 0.39% of employment. However, the fluctuations, there was fluctuations in growth of GDP. During 1985, it was 5.8, but it decreased during 1992. Again in 1997-2000, GDP had raised to 6.1%, then now it has 7 something in GDP growth rate. But employment was almost stable. Okay, it is almost stable. During this period, employment grew not more than 2%. So we can also find a widening gap between GDP and employment, especially in 2005-10. In 2005, the gap between growth in GDP and growth in the employment growth is showing a wider gap. So we have growth in GDP, at the same time we are not growing in employment, providing employment opportunities. So India facing the problem of jobless growth. So we have to analyze one more table to find out structural change in employment. So this table shows the sectoral wise and status wise employment pattern from 1972 to 2012. So in 1972-73, about 74.3% of workforce was engaged in which sector? Primary sector. And in 2009-10, this proportion has declined to 53.2%. Then secondary and service sector has showing promising future for the Indian workforce. During 1972-73, it was only 10.9% and 14.8% in respective sectors, but it is increased in 2011-12 to 24.3 and 26.8. Still, primary sector is the main employment provider. But when we compare it to the previous years, the share of employment provision is declining in primary sector. At the same time, in secondary and tertiary sector, the employment provision is increasing. Okay? When we talk about the status, over the last decade, that is 1972 to 2012, the people have moved from self-employed and regular salaried employed worker to casual works. Self-employed declined from 61.4% in 1972 and it declined to 52% in 2011-12. Then regular salaried employed shows a constant scenario, only 3% growth in this respect. Then, but in the case of casual labor, the engaged, the percentage of people engaged in casual employment is increased from 23.3 to 30% in 2011-12. 12. Here we can see the major portion of the populations were shifted from self-employed and regular salaried employee to casual wage laborers. But still, self-employment is the major employment provider in India. Then the process of moving from self-employment and regular salaried employment to casual work is known as casualization of workforce. So what is casualization of workforce? Shifting or moving from self-employment and regular salaried employment to casual work is known as casualization of workforce. This is also a major issue that India facing today. So we will discuss more about this casualization in the next class. So I am going to wind up here. So today we have discussed about what all things? We have discussed about the participation of workforce in secondary and tertiary sector, and also about jobless growth in India, and also the structural change in employment opportunities in India. All these are analyzed on the basis of data, chart and tables. So you need not to study the figures in table, but you have to explain tables and diagram. For this, you should read the textbook very well. So, children, don't forget to watch the URL and attend the test paper. Then download your study materials and learn it very well. So, see you, children. See you in the next class. Bye.